Hey, it's Rafael St. John here, the wealthy expat, teaching you how to lower your taxes legally, move abroad, get a second citizenship, go to countries that give you more freedom. The Western world now is feeling like it's getting less and less free by the day, and there are other countries that are popping up with much more freedom. And I recently got a question from one of you viewers here that said, I love Dubai and I love the United Arab Emirates and I love their tax policy, but I just don't feel like I want to live there. Some months of the year, it's unlivable. It's 50 degrees Celsius outside, over 100 Fahrenheit. It's quite harsh on you. And he just didn't want to live in Dubai. Where could I live that has a 0% tax policy, or at least a tax-friendly policy of 5%, 10%, but also I can live there all year. I can meet other kinds of people that are not in Dubai. I can have another lifestyle that is a little bit cheaper than Dubai as well. I'm gonna tell you four countries that you can go that have territorial-based tax systems, meaning that if you move to that country, and as long as all of your income is sourced from abroad, then you wouldn't need to pay taxes in those countries. You can set up a company somewhere else in another jurisdiction. That could be Dubai. That could be, if you're not a US citizen, could be a US LLC or any other type of company outside of that country, and make sure that all of your income is sourced from outside of the country, you could theoretically pay 0% or very close to 0%. You'll have maybe 1% or 2% here and there. So what are the four countries that have territorial-based tax systems now? There were a lot of countries that had that 6 months ago, 1 year ago. The laws have changed drastically. So the first one is the Republic of Georgia, an absolutely beautiful and stunning country. I've been to Georgia. I spent 1 month traveling around the country, went to Tbilisi, went to Batumi, went to all of these different small towns. There's a small town in the mountains called Kasbegi, which is amazing for winter. You can ski there. It's just absolutely beautiful. So Georgia actually has a territorial-based tax system where if you move to Georgia, you can get tax exemptions and basically pay a 0% tax rate as long as your income comes from outside of Georgia. Now it's not so easy to move to Georgia as it was 2-3 years ago. It's also not so easy to get Georgian citizenship. If you want to move to Georgia, you can get a residence permit investing about $100,000 USD. That's typically the amount that you need to invest into real estate or into other investments in order to get a residence permit. You can then renew that residence permit after a couple of years, or year by year by year, you can renew it and stay in Georgia as long as you like, but you need to have that initial $100,000 or more investment. Georgia is one of those countries that is quite popular with nomads and expats, but it's still not expensive. I was there 2 years ago and the prices really surprised me. For wine, for food, for renting, they're extremely cheap. An apartment in the center of the city, I paid $50 per day. And in Batumi, which is on the west part of the country, which is absolutely amazing, that place is one of those high value places where you pay very little and you get a really nice lifestyle. They're building up these nice skyscrapers or these nice high buildings. And I think I paid about $30 per night for a room on the 25th floor, on a very beautiful building right in front of the beach. So the value that you get for the money that you're spending is quite great, and you'll definitely enjoy that. Georgia is a country that I could see myself living full time, even though I don't want to live there full time. I want to travel all around other countries, but it could be a country that you could potentially live there. People are also quite friendly, even though a lot of them, specifically in the smaller towns, don't speak fluent English. People are also quite friendly and nice to foreigners, even though in the capital, I wouldn't say that much, but definitely in the smaller towns like Batumi, Kasbegi, or other towns around the country, they don't speak fluent English. They typically speak Russian or their local language, Georgian, which is, I think, pretty much impossible to learn. If you stay there 20 years, you'll probably learn the language, but it is pretty interesting how they write it and how they speak it. It is one of those beautiful languages. So speaking English, you might have some problems. A lot of younger people do speak fluent English. So if you talk to younger people, they'll definitely speak English, but you'll have a little bit of trouble with that. Not a big deal. You can always learn some words in Russian or learn Russian, and you can communicate very easily with people instead of learning Georgian. Even if you want to qualify for Georgian citizenship, then obviously you want to learn Georgian. But that's the first country. Absolutely lovely. and a country that I recommend people to visit and just spend some time there. The next very famous country would be Malaysia. Malaysia is a country that is very popular with expats, with very wealthy entrepreneurs that want to go to Malaysia because it has a territorial-based tax system where if you gain income from outside of Malaysia, you can theoretically pay 0% tax. Now, in order to move to Malaysia, it is getting harder. The MM2H, My Second Home program, has gotten a lot stricter and the requirements have gone up drastically. With the new requirements, if you want to move to Malaysia through that program, it's quite a sizable investment. So you need to, first of all, show a monthly income of about $9,500. So it's not an investment, it's actually just showing wealth and showing money and showing bank deposits and all of this. I misspoke there. So $9,500 per month income. Then you also need to have about $360,000 in liquid assets that you have. So you can't just go there with 50K and pretend like you can live in Malaysia. You need to have a sizable amount of net worth. Then you need to do a fixed deposit of $236,000, and you also need to spend 90 days per year in Malaysia. So we're talking about a almost $10,000 per month income. We're talking about a $360,000 liquid asset showing that you have that. We're talking about a fixed deposit of $236,000, and we're talking about 90 days per year living in Malaysia. Obviously, if you want to move to Malaysia, take advantage of their tax treatment and take advantage of their tax programs, then obviously you're going to spend more than 90 days, but you do need to have those liquid assets. You do need to have those deposits. Malaysia is getting more popular by the day, and they know that, and other countries that are next to them, like Singapore, are charging 2 million, 2.5 million to move there. They're upping the game, they're upping the fees and upping the amount that you need to spend and invest into the country. So definitely a very interesting country, a country that is developing extremely rapidly, absolutely beautiful, and has that vibe of Singapore. They are trying to improve the country as much as possible, inviting foreigners, even though with these changes, a lot of foreigners are going to leave Malaysia, but a lot of wealthy foreigners are going to spend time in Malaysia. It gives it a premium brand. So I think it's a country that is going to keep attracting attention, specifically from viewers like you that are wealthy expats. The next country on the list, one that is extremely popular, specifically with people from the West, like the US, Canada, and UK, is Panama. Panama also has a territorial tax system where you can pay 0% tax if all your money is sourced outside of Panama. So you could have a company that's based outside of Panama, and then you could live in Panama and not pay any taxes in Panama. They recently changed the friendly nations visa, which was a very easy way to immigrate to Panama. A lot of people were going to Panama, getting Panamanian citizenship, even though it's not as easy to get now. But now the requirements are a lot higher. There are a lot of options. Typically, the easiest option is to invest $300,000 into the country in a bank deposit or an investment into real estate. There are other smaller options, but it isn't as easy as it was before with just the cheap $5,000 friendly nations visa. So definitely Panama, very interesting country, very beautiful country that is well connected with a lot of other countries. Very easy to fly to the US, very easy to fly to South America, very easy to connect to Europe through the US and other countries. So definitely a country that is very interesting. If you like that Latino culture, if you like Panama City, which is bustling and a lot of people there, but also you like the other towns around Panama, maybe you want to go to the forest and so on. Definitely a country that is very interesting. It wouldn't be my first pick. My first pick out of these four, the fourth one is actually my first pick, but then it would be Georgia. So not the best one on this list, but definitely one to consider if you're looking for being close to home, close to the US, close to Canada, having a nice tax treatment and having just a better, cheaper, let's say Latino way of life. And then the last one that I added on this list, even though they are not a territorial tax system, but you could theoretically get a 0% tax rate, is Portugal. Portugal, through their golden visa and other types of visas, you could apply for NHR, non-habitual resident. What this means is that you get a 10-year tax vacation. Usually you'll have to pay a little bit of tax. It isn't 0% like it would be in Dubai or Georgia, for example, if you have that territorial tax system. In Portugal, you are paying a little, it's part of the EU. After 5 years, you can qualify for Portuguese permanent residence as well as Portuguese citizenship through the Golden Visa or through any other program. A lot of people like the D7 visa, specifically people that want to spend all their time in Portugal, but you could do the Golden Visa. make an investment into real estate, make an investment into a fund. I've made a lot of videos about the Portugal Golden Visa. You can check out the requirements in the tab here that's gonna pop up and see exactly what you need for that program. But definitely a beautiful country, very interesting country, well connected to the whole world. You can go in car to anywhere in Europe. So it's definitely a country that I wanna spend more time in. I wanna be a citizen of in the next 5 or 6 years, and a country that is attracting a lot of foreigners. Now they're changing their golden visa rules. So obviously that is going to attract less people, but it's going to attract more wealthy people, people that are willing to invest more money into the country. So I think this is the direction that a lot of these countries are going towards, is let's attract more people, but people that have more money. So maybe attract a less amount of people, but a bigger amount of money and a bigger amount of that premium type of person that we want, that elite that we want coming to our country, not just backpackers, not just people that have $10,000, but people that have $10 million. So that's the way that I see all these countries going. I think Portugal, extremely interesting. If you're also looking for that higher level citizenship in the next 5 years, maybe you wanna replace your US passport or just get a much better passport, Portugal, definitely an extremely interesting option. So those are three, plus the bonus one of Portugal, territorial-based tax system where you can potentially pay 0% or very close to 0% while living in that country. And they're also a little bit more livable than, let's say, the United Arab Emirates, where 5 months of the year is extremely hot. So if you're looking to spend all of your time in a particular country, but also get that freedom, also get a nice tax treatment without having to make those compromises of being in the UAE, then I put together this list for you. If you want help moving to any of these countries or getting a citizenship, a residence permit, lowering your taxes down to as close to zero as possible, book an application call with that link in the description, wealthyexpat.com/apply. Let's sit down one-on-one and see if I can help you lower your taxes, move abroad, get other residence permits, and create more freedom in your life. This is my service. This is what I do for people, and we're excited to help you in that process. If you want to learn more about tax systems, about how to lower your taxes, how to legally pay less in taxes, check out the video that is going to pop up here, or how to legally never pay taxes or pay as close to zero as possible. You're going to love my strategies that I detail in that video. Subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell for more content like this, and click that like button down below if you enjoyed the video. I will see you on the next one.